Go.
All right.
That'll be up for debate later.
So, Jewel versus Dell, this is what I was interested in seeing, the Robin versus Rob matchup here. Rob is the original Rob, I suppose you could say. But, Robin, does the IN bring enough to the table to make this a winning matchup?
Shut up. I'm done listening to this. Here we go. So, we got Robotic Operating Buddy.
Yep.
This is Dill's original main back in Super Smash Bros. Brawl.
No joke.
Yeah, and then he didn't like him in Smash 4. Then when Ultimate came out, he was still kind of just sticking with Diddy Kong and other characters. He didn't want to go to Rob. Everyone's like, dude, he's good now. Just play him. And now he's finally playing the character. And look at all the work he is putting in. Already has Jewel at 118%, just keeping him off stage by throwing all his projectiles. All
right, good tech right there. Even if he went for the hard read off stage up there, doesn't suffer too much for it. Gets 20%, goes back to neutral, resets. So, if we noticed earlier on, Jewel had a couple of the good parries there. Dill, very fond of Nair. Robin General gets a lot of mileage out of Nair and the down tilt. And Jewel was aware enough to parry both like that.
Ooh.
That'll determine a big part of this matchup here is being able to shut down Rob's offense.
And honestly, if anyone knows the item gameplay, it's going to be Jewel. You saw him using the gyro to his favor to get the combos off of it. He knows his routes.
Absolutely.
Forward air, tries to get the spike with the stat down.
Still hits him.
That lasted for a very long time, I think because he hit the gyro.
No, you know what I think that was? I think that was the book from
Elwin. You're right. Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
He
yeah.
definitely hit something because that down air lasted a kind of a hot second.
Mm-hmm.
To be able to get to the hitbox. There we go. Elwin, kind of a predictable recovery, allows Dill to set up that down air extremely nicely.
And let's not lie, Dill is real good at getting that 2-frame. Mm. He has gotten a lot of practice with that. All right.
It's a meaty hitbox. It stays out for a long time, you know?
It is. All right, Rob going for the juggles on the platforms here. Not too much right now. He wants to try to land something to get forward momentum going. All right, good response. Jewel not giving up too much ground here, which is very important against Rob. You don't want to give him enough time to set up and get his combos.
This is the up air again.
Right. See, that was a good B reverse if he hadn't come in and shielded it.
Right.
All right.
Oh, we're going super off there with an arm rotor.
Yep. Gets the safe recovery with the arc fire there. I've never actually seen it drop down and get people with a neutral getup before from recovery.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes when it does, like, it can catch a lot of people off guard, you know? Jewel's sitting at 123.
All right. He's right now. Yep, tornado.
Smart stuff. You notice that he had a lot of options covered with that neutral air. It covers ledge jump, ledge get up, and ledge attack. And the second he lands back down on the ground in case he wants to delay it, he had the arm rotor ready to go instantly. So the only thing that would have been safe for Jewel was to either let go of the ledge and come back on or go for a roll.
And that's a really scary option to take against Rob because, like you said, that down air has a lot of active frames. If you go off stage, you're basically sentencing yourself to death.
Yep.
And Rob has no commitment to do it either. So even if he messes up, he's back on stage, you have to work to get back. It's a heart attack for arguably very little reward.
Yeah, gotta look out for that cardiac arrest, you know?
Mm-hmm. Very good cross up with the bear right there. Rob's pressure actually.
Ooh. Got the down tilt. I mean, honestly, that down tilt for Rob, extremely strong tool.
Absolutely. Very good, still very fast. I don't know if it's as fast as it was in Smash 4, but an excellent tool.
The fact
combos into itself.
Yeah, because the fact that you can dash into a down tilt allows him to be able to chain it together over and over on the stage. Now he's got Jewel at 121%, but some great setups coming out from Jewel himself. Has him high, flying in the air.
Catches him.
Dill cannot land. No. That stage, none of that was his control, man. It was like he had Boardwalk, Park Place, and the rest of the map.
But now, see, he's got to set up his hotels, but you've got to look out for that mortgage.
Oh, okay.
He's coming in with the books.
That was a good stretch. I like it.
All right.
151% on Jewel offstage.
Oh,
got some
of
the sour spot.
No.
Gets the spike. Again, down air, very susceptible to down air because of Elwin. The problem with Elwin is there is no active hitbox above Robin.
Mm-hmm.
So there's no way for him to hit the opponent while trying to recover, like similar to like say like Dolphin Slash from Martha and Lucina.
Absolutely. And Rob down air, Ivysaur. If Ivysaur has the Spirit Bomb, Rob has the Final Flash. Look at that.
Yeah. Perfectly timed from Dill. Had that slow-mo for a very long time, so you get like, we slow-mo'd the slow-mo. So that you can just see those like sparks flying. Now Jewel's got to think of something, or else he's going to go home with a fifth place finish. Dill on the cusp of moving on to loser semis.
He's getting ready.
Now for an update, that King Arc versus Mr. Reset is still going on, I think, or no one's updating the bracket.
No problem. We will see.
I think it's the latter.
Yeah, honestly. We'll find out who the opponent is later.
Next time on Dragon Ball Z.
Oh!
We find you. Oh!
Oh!
The music counterpick?
Piano.
Is this Gladion or which one is this? I forget.
The bees.
The bees?
That's all I think of when I hear this song. I'm not good with Pokemon music, unfortunately. I didn't like grow up. I grew up with Red and Blue, and then like I just did. I didn't continue after that.
It's all good. I played. I only ever owned Emerald, and I think I maybe touched like Diamond and Pearl once in high school. I was like, "Yo, that's a new Pokemon game. Let me see." Okay, cool. And then I never touched
Cynthia.
It.
Beekeeper.
Yes.
That's right. Yeah.
Oh my!
I knew the word bee was somewhere in there.
Yo, deep mental neural pathways. Bee hair, bees.
Yeah. Well, the song makes you think of bees because of the way it sounds.
All right.
All right. Here we go. Oh no. Okay.
Oh.
Bee. Mm. Okay. That's fine. Whatever. Whatevs. Whatevs.
So that's a very disheartening start. Losing a stock early like that, especially with so little percent on the board, is very hard mentally to come back from, but
honestly, especially when you already like lost the game one, to have like that much of a deficit already to start off the game is just a huge tragedy for Jewel.
Mm-hmm. But remember, this is just like the champion battle. You know, it may seem like a very hard fight, but you got to earn that belt. You got to get that trophy. You got to get your name in the halls of history. All right, going for the parries, a lot of them there. Very aggressive. It is a punishable habit in this one. Rob, maybe not so much because a lot of his moves that he wants to start with are single hit or kind of delayed, so you can't do them on reaction.
And Dill was applying a lot of shield pressure there. You know,
oh my god.
We go. Back air, baby.
All right. This is looking more and more dire every moment. He hasn't come in with any full restores. He got one burn heal and an ultra ball, and it's not going to work on the champion battle.
Okay, that shield looking super small too. Almost like got to a point where he could have potentially broken Dill's shield, but now one stock to three, things are looking bleak. Has him off stage without his double jump. He immediately goes for the L1 to get back onto the stage.
Yep. Jewel playing aggressive though. He's not afraid, and he knows he needs to pull something out against this.
All right, and respecting the down tilt coming in, charging up the thunder into an arc.
See, that was a wavelength and a good B reverse there as well, but Dill's just been on top of him. Every time he's gone for that option, that's it.
Oh my god. Disgusting destruction from Dill. We got him at three stocks. Didn't take a single one. He's going to move on to loser semis to fight off against Mr. E, who sought victory over King Arc.
And I hesitate to call that a wash, but my god, that was rough.
He gave him a bath, dude. I don't care. Like that's what I was. It all started with that light, because what happened with that very first stock is he re-grabbed the ledge, right? That's what happened. So because he re-grabbed it, there was no invincibility, so it just kind of... And he also chilled there for a bit, so Dill was just like, okay, and then he down-aired. Like, so it's just like, not the greatest start for Jewel, so he's going to be going home with a fifth place finish, tying alongside King Arc.